Hi, good morning. I'm Dr. Surakshith Battina from Indigo Womens Center, Chennai. And as a part of our Baby for All initiative, we are going to educate the public regarding women's health and fertility. In our previous video, which you can check out over here, we have described on what are the 10 reasons why you should enter into a fertility clinic or why you should go and visit a fertility specialist. And in today's video, we are going to discuss about how to choose your fertility clinic or what are the things to consider before choosing a fertility clinic. The most important factor to consider prior to choosing your clinic is that you need to understand what is the qualification of the doctor and as well as what is the experience what he holds. Sometimes, you know, in India, you even have anesthetists who are practicing fertility medicine. So it's always essential for you to do a background check on the doctor. Get an idea of what is his experience prior to you going to his center, his or her center. Another question what you need to ask yourself is, will this same doctor sit and consult me every single time? If in case they have a large number of chain of hospitals, the chances are that he's not going to be there every time you visit the hospital. The second question what you need to ask yourself is, will the doctor completely investigate the reason for my infertility or will I be over-investigated? What I mean by this is, unfortunately in India we have two extremes of clinics. Either in one extreme of clinics you have people directly going in for IVF without any investigations, and in the other extreme you have people going with a complete protocol of investigations, whether the patient requires those investigations or not. So I would always suggest go in for a clinic which follows individualized treatments. Always be aware of how much the treatment is going to set you back. Many times, you know, you get lured by marketing techniques like, you know, IVF for 20,000 Indian rupees and 30,000 Indian rupees, but unfortunately that is not the case. Once you're lured into the hospital, chances are that they're going to increase the price or you're going to finally pay more than what you're expecting to pay. So I would always suggest that don't fall in for marketing gimmicks. Always find out what is the actual cost of IVF or what is the actual cost of ICSI at that particular hospital prior to starting your treatment. Chances are that if you are going to undergo treatment for that low price, that you are not going to get your optimal treatment at all. When the doctor advises fertility treatment for you, always ask what are your chances of achieving pregnancy rather than the hospital statistics. You might only look at the pregnancy rate and not live birth rates. If you think a clinic or a hospital follows a batching system, it's always better to avoid such a clinic, because not every individual responds to medications the same particular way. At the same time, you know, not every individual has the growth of the follicles at the same rate. So it's always better to have an individualized treatment for you, and find out clinics where they don't do batching systems or they don't stimulate people at the same time, they don't do the egg collections at the same time. Most IVF clinics only run as a daycare center from 9 a.m. to 5 p.m. So I would suggest if the hospital does not provide you with an emergency contact number, it's better not to go in for that particular clinic. Always choose a hospital which is near to your place and also has provided you with an emergency contact number in cases of emergencies. Before choosing your clinic, also ask or find out from the hospital whether they do embryo transfers and egg collections on weekends or at odd timings. Your embryos and eggs do not really care of what day of the week it is, so neither should your fertility specialist. Choose or consider a clinic which does not have this no weekend policy for egg retrievals or no weekend policies for embryo transfers, and they are open throughout the day of the week no matter what, and that makes a lot of difference actually, because if the eggs are not mature and you have the egg retrieval done and just because it's a Friday, I would suggest to stay away from such clinics. Some corporates have the sonologists changing in day in and day out. You have a sonologist coming in the morning and then the same sonologist might not be there the next day. So always before joining into a clinic, find out if the same person is going to monitor your follicles. Then because of this person-to-person variability, the follicles might not be monitored accurately. Another point to note is that you should never fall in for marketing gimmicks and money back offers. You know, unlike cell phones, these are not things which you could buy. These are fairly expensive treatments, and all of them come with a cost. If you actually believe that, you know, you are going to get your money back if the cycle fails, then you're absolutely wrong. If by chance you're offered a money back offer, the chances are that you're being conned into paying more than what you should. So you pay in for at least 3 or 4 cycles when we know for a fact that you're going to get pregnant the very first cycle. So do not fall in for this trap, and always make sure that, you know, you only pay for one cycle and not more than that. No hospital is going to do a free treatment, so the whole idea about money back offers or money back schemes is a big sham. And finally, I would always say, don't listen to what you hear on TV. The chances are that, you know, your fertility specialist might say something else, but they might always treat another way. So I would always suggest to visit 2 or 3 hospitals or 2 or 3 clinics prior to making a decision on one fertility hospital, because chances are you're going to see that same place more than once. I would also suggest try to find out the philosophy of your treating specialist, because his philosophy and mentality has to match with yours. Because once you make that decision, it's always better to follow with one fertility clinic rather than trying to hop in from one place to another. So I hope you found this video useful. If you did, kindly give us a like and share this video. And if you need to know more information about fertility treatments, kindly subscribe to our channel. And we'll be putting up more videos soon. Thank you.